Hello students, guests and colleagues. I'm part of the artist duo Nicole Six and Paul Petrich. Since 1997, we have been making films and artist books, taking photographs, presenting displays and context-specific installations, and realizing projects in public space. We live in Vienna. In my talk, I will discuss the most characteristic parts of our teaching program. I will start with a brief presentation of our curriculum and then using specific examples from a project with students. I will describe a possible outcome. At this point, I would like to thank Vít Havranek and Tomáš Švanek for their invitation to participate in the symposium. I'm very glad to be part of this event. I work at the University of Applied Arts and am in charge of setting up and running the Department of Site-Specific Art, which is part of the Institute of Fine Arts and Media Art. Our neighbors and sister disciplines are the departments of photography, graphics, painting and animated film, and sculpture and space. From a historical perspective and with reference to the landscape and institutional critique, site-specific art has focused above all on outdoor space as a site of production and reception. One might say that the resistance, the opposition directed at an institutional framework, is already implemented here. With this in mind, the department is addressing these concepts in a discussion that is very topical today. We want to re-examine the classical work and presentation spaces of art, the studio, the gallery and the museum. This is the point of departure of our investigation. Our curriculum adheres the profile description of the Institute of Fine Arts, defines the goals, scope, structure, the admission exam, the division into the first and second study segments, the so-called main artistic subject, and the master thesis. To sum up the main points, the diploma program begins with the student passes the entrance exam. The main artistic subject, derived from the master class system, is the core of the study program. Completing individual artistic projects, working with text, attending individual meetings, group discussions, and technically implementing projects or work in the studios and workshops foster the students' independence and autonomy. Furthermore, we expand the focus of our curriculum by offering opportunities to visit exhibitions, work on projects, go on excursions, and attend guest lecturers together. Our department has studios, lecture halls, wood, metal, mold making, and digital workshops. Our own in-house exhibition space gives passerby a glimpse into what we do and presents itself to the city. The space can be used for university as well as external projects. The main artistic subject is backed by lectures. It is divided into 5 main categories: artistic and research practice, scientific and research practice, artistic practice in technical context, economic and organizational practice, and free electives. Now that I have given an overview of our study program, I would like to briefly describe a very specific project, the Walk Around Vienna, die Umrundung von Wien. Our city, the city in which we live and work and study, will be the point of departure and focus of the project. We will circumnavigate it on foot. The Walk Around Vienna will take an entire work week. Our average walking speed might be 5 kilometers per hour. At the same time, however, due to the Earth's rotation, we will cover a distance of 1,670 kilometers per hour. 107,208 kilometers due to the Earth revolving around the Sun, and 960,000 kilometers due to the Sun revolving around the center of the galaxy. Examination modus: the group stays together. Our idea was that teaching is always influenced by hierarchy and other institutional conditions, and this in turn has to do with budget, equipment, exhibition space, and audience. These constraints, in conjunction with the lesson, have always bothered us. With this project, we seek to counteract these factors. We step outside, we start walking. We experience our own city in a new way, not in an everyday sense, but away from a daily work, away from a social network. We need no budget, no workshops, no exhibition space, no audience. We walk as individuals, as a group, as artists. I sent the symposium organizers my proposal to speak about the walk around Vienna, and Wied wrote back the following: Dear Paul, thank you very much. Your proposal fits very well within the symposium scope. One remark: if you could develop it in one direction, would be great. If such a project serves a key study as model for pedagogical activity, what kind of curricula it would generate? Do you think that art pedagogy could consist only from deep intellectual and physical interdisciplinary projects? Or do we still need teaching of classical matters? And what kind of new school organization experience of your project could generate? Even despite thinking about my subject for the symposium and Wied's email, I don't have a steadfast answer to these questions. My impression is that the curriculum can be a reference point and guideline. Artistic training, which is above all based on the development of resistance and specialization can at best follow these from time to time, but ultimately must run counter to it. While I'm writing these lines, I receive a message from my university. Due to the lockdown, the university building is closed, and not being able to get into the studios, some of the students in our program have occupied an empty lot. They are currently living and working there. A university staff member asks me in her email if I'm aware of this and who is legally responsible. Since I had no knowledge of the occupation of the empty lot, I'm beginning to think the curriculum might be working.